Hello, my name is Sabim. I'm a researcher, ex-master student working at National Taipei University of Technology in Taiwan. I'm just 26 years old. In 1989, my parents were 20 years old. So I guess when the Berlin Wall fell, that was just a wish in my parents' mind. When I was a kid, I wanted to become a Formula One driver. This wish didn't become true. However, I'm an engineer and I work with electric vehicles, which still gives me satisfaction. I'm the winner of Falling Walls Lab Taipei, and today I'm going to show you how to break the wall of battery charging technology. Lithium-ion batteries, the mainstream nowadays. This year, the lithium-ion battery market is worth around $44.2 billion and is recognized in the next 5 years will more than double, because these batteries are the most important technology in electric vehicles, which saw an average growing trend of 60% each year in the last 5 years. But in EV application, when the battery reaches just 80% of their life, need to be changed with new ones, because the vehicle will not achieve the initial driving range and the initial power output. This aspect will create 11 million tons of battery waste each year from EVs in the next 10 years, and today, less than 5% of the batteries are recycled. How can we reduce the waste from EV batteries? And my answer is, when the battery life is extended and the battery will stay in use as long as possible, this will reduce the production of the batteries and further reduce the waste from the batteries. But how can we increase the life of the battery? And here step my research. During my master studies in my lab, we developed a new charging method for lithium-ion batteries, which is called Composite Sinusoidal Waveform Charging Method. And basically, we apply voltage in the form of a sinusoidal wave divided of two stages. The first stage, we apply a high positive voltage, which is designed to be very efficient in making the charging fast. And the second stage, we apply a lower negative voltage. And this is what makes this charging special. This negative voltage will reverse and reduce the formation of solid electrolyte interface, or SEI, which is a major degradation effect in today's lithium-ion batteries. Now, some of the results I've collected. In the upper side of the graph, you can see 100 cycles experiment of the composite sine wave, and for comparison, a commercial fast charging method used in today's electric vehicle supercharging stations. After 100 cycles with the composite sine wave method, the battery will retain 11% more capacity, which is a big improvement for the battery life. And further, with our method, the battery will charge 20% faster with an average of 6 degrees Celsius lower internal heat generation. And this factor is making this charging superior to other charging methods. And another usage of this method, we take a lithium-ion battery that is already used and aged with the commercial charging method, and we apply the composite sine wave strategy, which will reverse the lithium complexes trapped during SEI formation and will recover some of the battery capacity. Can be seen in the lower graph, after 10 cycles with our method, the battery recovers 14.5% of the capacity lost during their lifetime. This will give the battery a secondary use and makes the battery overall more sustainable. I think the key point of my research is when applying a negative voltage step during charging a lithium-ion battery may improve over time the battery life, because this negative voltage will stabilize and reverse the formation of solid electrolyte interface, and in some cases may revive some of the capacity lost of the aged batteries. And designing the charging voltage in the form of sinusoidal wave may let the charging process more efficient, charging the battery faster with a lower internal heat generation. First of all, if the battery life can be extended using our charging strategy, in a non-expensive way, without changing the battery internal structure, just by modifying we charge these batteries, this will reduce the battery production and further reduce the waste from batteries, and of course, reduce the pollution. If you produce less, you pollute less, right? And secondly, using our charging method will decrease the charging time. Who wants to spend a lot of time charging his vehicle? I don't. And not just your vehicle, also your smartphone, your laptop, basically everything that contains a lithium-ion battery. Everyone can benefit from the advantages of this charging strategy. I'm wondering if this charging method could become commercially available, so everyone could benefit from this. Most of us, including me, wants the electric vehicles to succeed in the market as soon as possible, to have a cleaner world, and this charging method could help.